गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू फाइनाइट एलिमेंट मेथड्स ट्यूटोरियल। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स। फर्स्ट वन इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ फेम, historical background of FEM, steps of the finite element methods, general description of finite element methods, comparison of finite element method with other methods of analysis, advantages of FEM, limitations of FEM, applications of FEM. Definition of FEM. FEM is a numerical technique for finding approximate solution to boundary value problems for partial differential equations. It is also referred to as finite element analysis. It subdivides a large problem into smaller parts that are called finite elements. Or another definition is a complex region defining a continuum is discretized into simple geometric shapes called finite elements. This is the simple definition of finite element methods. Historical background of FEM. In 1909, Ridge developed an effective method for approximate solution of problems in the mechanics of deformable solids. It includes an approximation of energy functional by the known function with unknown coefficients, minimization of functional in relation to each unknown leads to the system of equations from which the unknown coefficients may be determined. In 1943, Courant considerably increased the possibilities of the Ridge method by introduction of special linear functions defined over triangular regions and applied the methods for the solution of torsional problems. As unknowns, the values of functions in the node points of triangular regions were chosen. Many years later, Clough introducing the term finite element in the paper Finite Element Method in Plane Space Analysis in 1960. The main reason of wide spreading of FEM in 1960s possibility to use computers for the big volume of computations required. The next important topic is steps of the finite element method. The analysis of a structure by the finite element method can be divided into several distinctive steps. These steps are to a large extent similar to the steps defined for the matrix method. In this first step is discretization. Discretization is the process of dividing the problem into several small elements connected with nodes. All elements and nodes must be numbered. Second step is element analysis. The element analysis have two key points. First one is expressing the displacement within the elements. Second one is maintaining equilibrium of the elements. Third step is assembly. The element equation for each element in the FEM assembled into a set of global equations that are the nodal properties of entire system. Fourth step is boundary conditions. This reflects the known values for certain primary unknowns. Imposing the boundary conditions modify the global equation. Next step is finding global displacements. Solve the primary unknowns. The modified global equation are solved for the primary unknowns at the nodes. By using Hooke's law, F equal to K into U. Next step is calculate derived variables. Derived values are calculated by using the nodal values of the primary variables. Last step is calculation of stresses. The stresses are determined from the strains by Hooke's law. Strains are derived from the displacement functions within the element combined with Hooke's law. Hooke's law means stress is directly proportional strain. Stress equal to Young's modulus into strain. Next topic is general description of finite element method. The finite element method is described as a numerical method to obtain approximate solutions to a wide variety of mostly complex problems arise in different engineering fields. In this method of analysis, a complex problem or region define a continuum or domain is discretized, that means splitted into simple geometric shapes called as subdomains, which are interconnected at some critical points. The subdomain are represented as finite elements and the interconnecting points are termed as nodal points or nodes. The material properties and the governing relationships like applied force and the resultant displacement, etc., are imposed on subdomains, and suitable simultaneous equations are formulated for all elements. Solutions of these equations gives us the approximate behavior of the continuum, that is, the sum of the elemental solutions will provide the required approximate solution for the whole domain or system. The previous discussion of process of finite element analysis can be specified by three stages of activity, such as pre-processing, processing, and post-processing. Pre-processing involves the preparation of data such as nodal coordinates, connectivity, boundary conditions, loading, and material information. The processing stage involves stiffness generation, stiffness modification, and solution of equations resulting in the evaluation of nodal variables, other derived quantities such as gradients and gradients or stresses may be evaluated at this stage. The post-processing stage deals with the presentation of results, typically the deformed configuration, stress distribution, temperature effects are computed and displayed at this stage. Next topic, comparison of finite element method with other methods of analysis. In finite element method, the whole domain can be divided into number of smaller elements of convenient sizes and shapes, and the behavior of elements are analyzed due to the applied load and other boundary conditions, and so these elements, the properties of whole domain can be decided, whereas in other methods, the entire system is analyzed by taking it as a single product. Division of big size and complicated system into smaller and simple shaped elements, solving the problem becomes easy, which we cannot expect in the other methods of analysis. The main drawback of finite element method is due to the formation many number of elements, the solution procedure will be lengthier and finding solution will require lot of calculations which can be carried out manually, and hence we have to depend on a computer for solution. Advantage of FEM. It can handle very complex geometry. It can handle a wide variety of engineering problems like solid mechanics, dynamics, heat problems, electrostatic problems. It can handle complex restraints, that is, indeterminate structures can be used. It can handle complex loadings, that is, a nodal load means point load, element load, that is, pressure, thermal, inertia forces, time or frequency depending loads. Other advantages are model irregular shaped bodies quite easily, handle general load conditions without difficulty, model bodies composed of several different materials because the element equations are evaluated individually, handle unlimited numbers and kinds of boundary conditions, vary the size of the element to make it possible to use small elements wherever necessary. Alter the finite element model easily and cheaply, include dynamic effects, handle nonlinear behavior existing with large deformation and nonlinear materials. These are the few advantages of FEM. Limitations of FEM. The finite element method is a time-consuming process, that is, it requires longer time for solving. In order to analyze many number of smaller elements due to human fatigue, we have to depend on computer package. The result obtained using FEM will be closer to exact solution only if the system is divided into number of smaller elements. Otherwise, there may be considerable variation from the exact solution. FEM cannot produce exact results as those of analytical methods. If we are not having sound background in mathematics, especially in matrix algebra, differentiation and integration, then solving problem using FEM is highly difficult. Application of finite element methods. The finite element method is mostly used in the field of structural mechanics. Also, it has been successfully applied to solve several other types of engineering problems like heat transfer, fluid dynamics, deformation and stress analysis of automobile and aircraft, electric and magnetic fields. Area of studies, civil engineering structures. Analyzing problems is analysis of trusses, frames, folded plates, shell roofs, bridges, and pre-stressed concrete structures, shear walls. Area of studies, aircraft structures. In this, analysis of aircraft wings, fins, rockets, spacecraft, and missile structures. Mechanical design. Stress analysis of pressure vessels, pistons, composite materials, linkages, and gears. Heat conduction. In this study of temperature distribution in solids and fluids. Hydraulics and water resources engineering. The problem analysis is analysis of potential flows, free surface flows, viscous flows, analysis of hydraulic structures and dams. Electrical machines and electromagnetics. In this study of analysis of synchronous and induction machines, eddy current and core losses in electric machines. Nuclear engineering. Analysis of nuclear pressure vessels and containment structures. Geomechanics. Stress analysis in soils, dams, layered piles, and machine foundations. Biomedical engineering. In this, stress analysis of eyeballs, bones, and teeth. Mechanics of heart valves. These are the few applications of finite element methods. In next topic, we will discuss about discretization of domain, discretization process, types of elements, element division, element stiffness matrix, properties of stiffness matrix, assembly of global stiffness matrix and load vector, formulation of finite element equations, types of boundary conditions, treatment of boundary conditions, convergence of finite element solutions. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.